Good morning, students. Welcome to the another session of chemistry for 11th class. We are in the first chapter with different topics. In our previous discussion, we were discussing about empirical formula and molecular formula. To determine the empirical formula and the molecular formula, we should know the knowledge of percentage composition. So using the percentage composition, dividing it by gram atomic mass, we got relative mole number of moles. Then by dividing with least number among the relative number of moles, we got the mole ratio. Then afterwards, we determined empirical formula. From the empirical formula, we have calculated empirical mass. So by dividing molecular mass, which is given in the question, by empirical mass, we got the value for N. After knowing the value for N, we have determined the molecular formula, which is equal to empirical formula N times. So these were the steps to determine molecular formula using the percentage composition. Now today, one more interesting topic we are discussing. It is limiting reagent, or it is called limiting reactants. Okay, I want to burn 1 kilo wood. What I do? I bring 1 kilo wood. Then I start burning in the atmosphere or in air. Here, wood starts burning. But remember, 1 kilo wood to burn, how much air is required for burning as a supporter of combustion? It takes how much it wants, that much only. Though the excess amount of air is available, though the large amount of oxygen is available in the air, but 1 kilogram of wood requires how much air, that much only it will take. What I want to discuss here today, I think you understood. Here, the amount of wood is fixed. It is 1 kilogram. But the amount of air, which is not fixed, it is in large excess. But 1 kilo wood, how much it wants? It is taking from the large amount of air. So here, wood amount is less, air amount is excess. The amount which is in less is known as a limiting agent, limiting chemical, limiting material, limiting reactant. See, the one which is in the limiting amount, that will control the reaction, because it is 1 kilogram decides how much products has to form. Depend upon the amount of the limiting reagent, amount of product is formed. One more example. For your house, let us think, two guests have come, okay, and you are preparing tea for them. You will go to the kitchen. But after going to the kitchen, you will come to know that milk available is only 1 cup. What you will do? You will prepare, but you will prepare 1 cup of tea and you will request them to share. Means, here sugar is there, tea powder is there, everything is there. But the amount of milk is less. So to make tea, milk is restricting. So the amount of milk is restricting you to go for the 1 cup of milk only. You could have added the water, that is separate issue, but we want to go for the good quality tea, you know, for the guest. So to prepare a very good quality of tea for your guest in the available 1 cup of milk, so you have to go for 1 cup of tea only, so that you can share between two. Sometimes what happens, 2 cups of milk is available, tea powder is available, but after opening the sugar box, you will come to know sugar is less. Again, what will go? You'll go for again either 1 cup or 1.5 cup, depend upon the how much sugar is available at present now in the kitchen. Third case, sugar is available, milk is large, full 1 liter is available, but tea powder is not available, very little amount, hardly 1 spoon. So, in that 1 spoon of tea powder, how much tea you can prepare? That means your tea preparation depends upon the how much amount of raw material is available. Whether all the three are in large amount or one is a less amount, the one which is in the less amount, that will restrict you to go for the tea preparation. In chemistry also, whenever two elements or the two compounds are reacting, if both reactants goes as per the balanced chemical equation, then no problem. By chance, out of the two or more reactants which are participating in the chemical reaction, if one is in less amount than the balanced chemical equation, that is called as the limiting reagent or the limiting reactant. So depend upon its availability in the reaction, that is used completely with the remaining amount of the reactant and forms the product. So formation of product depends upon the limiting reactant. So today we discuss what is meant by limiting reagent or the limiting reactant, which is controlling the reaction, and the product formation depends upon the limiting reagent. See, limiting reagent, in one phrase you can understand, limiting reagent is the one exhausted first. I told you, no? It is the one which is in the less amount will be consumed first. What is excess reagent? It is the reactants remained. For example, in the case of wood example I took, wood is the limiting reagent, limiting reactant, whereas the air is excess reagent, excess chemical, excess reactant. So limiting reagent is the one exhausted first, and the excess reagent is the one or the reactants remained. Now here is one small understanding diagrammatically. Okay, two rectangular squares are there. This is one reactant. Two triangular reactants with different color. This is the second reactant. Both are reacting. Okay, but what is the product here? Product formed is for one triangle. We want two rectangles, blue color rectangle. So one red color or maroon color rectangle requires two blue color rectangles. This is the formula for the product. So to form this one, we require one triangle and two rectangle. Now see here, what you have taken in the reactant side, we have taken two rectangles and the two triangles. So according to the balanced chemical equation, one triangle requires two blue color rectangles. Okay, so this is the product, this is the product formed here, right? Now this will remain as it is, unreacted. See, he has shown here, this is remained unreacted. That means which is in large amount? This is in large amount. So this is in the small amount. If you want to react this triangle, we want two more blue color rectangles. Therefore, this is in the large amount. One reactant remains unreacted. So this is called excess reagent or the excess reagent, whereas this is called limiting reagent. So the question is, which one is the limiting reactant? It is a blue colored rectangle. Now actual example is here. 2 moles of ammonia react with 5/2 moles of oxygen to give 2 nitric oxide and 3 water molecules. This is a very famous equation we are going to learn in the 12th class under the heading preparation of nitric acid by the oxidation of ammonia by the very famous method known as Ostwald process. From that we have taken this example. Okay, so you see the balanced chemical equation is 2 moles of ammonia, 5/2 moles of oxygen gives 2 moles of nitric oxide and 3 moles of water. This is balanced chemical equation for the formation of nitric oxide. But how much I have taken in the laboratory? I have taken 4 moles of ammonia and I have taken 2.5 moles of oxygen. How much is formed? Okay, how much is formed we'll think afterwards. But out of two, which one is limiting reagent? Okay, now we'll go according to the stoichiometry, balanced chemical equation. 2 moles of ammonia requires, what is 5/2? 5/2 is 2 2s are 4, this is 2.5 mole. Okay, so 2 moles of ammonia requires 2.5 moles of oxygen, but I have taken 4 moles, I have taken extra moles, so this is extra.
So for 2.5 moles of oxygen, I require only 2 moles of ammonia according to the balanced chemical equation, according to the law of conservation of mass. But I have taken 4 moles. That means 2.5 mole is limiting, it is restricting the reaction, and it is taking out of 4 only 2 moles. 2 moles of ammonia will remain unreacted. So ammonia is known as excessive reagent, whereas oxygen is known as limiting reagent, and this is controlling the reaction. Depend upon the amount of limiting reagent available, product is formed. So I think the term limiting reagent is clear from these two examples. To add to this, one more example here. I have taken in one container 4 hydrogen molecules, H2, 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 and in another container I have taken 3 molecules of oxygen. Now I want to prepare water, H2O. Okay, now what is the formula for H2O? According to the law of definite proportion, so the ratio of hydrogen to oxygen in one molecule of water is 2:1 by volume. 2 hydrogen atoms are required for 1 oxygen atom, so that 1 water molecule is formed. Now to form 1 water molecule here from 2 hydrogen and 1 O, see, so 2 hydrogen and 1 O only, 1 water, 2 hydrogen, 1 more O here, 2 molecules of water, third with this one, third water molecule, okay, sorry, this 2, huh? 2H2, 1O, okay, this is 2H2, 1 more O, ho gaya. Now, this is 2H2, 1O, this is 2H2, 1 more, ho gaya. That means, for 3H2, we have used what? We have used only 2. So still 1 is there, no? 1O2 is remained unreacted here. That means this is in the large excess. Extra amount is available here, but here it is not available. So for this much amount of oxygen, more amount of hydrogen is required. So that's why it is in less amount. That means hydrogen is the limiting reactant or the limiting reagent, whereas this is excess reactant. This is written here only. And this is a very important statement here. Amount of product is determined by limiting reactant or the limiting reagent. So this will decide how much product has to form. Depend upon the amount of sugar, amount of the sugar, or amount of the tea powder, amount of the milk, your tea preparation is there. So you can compare that reaction, everyday example, with this. So it is the limiting reagent which will restrict the chemical reaction, and it will determine the amount of product formation.